A former Goucher student, author Annie Lamott, wrote a book that identifies three essential prayers: help, thanks, wow. They are indeed familiar, I think, to all of us as impulses of our souls. And I would add sorry as a fourth human impulse and need. These four seem fitting for today, this day that we celebrate achievement and learning and growth. So as we begin, I offer these words, drawing on these familiar impulses. We offer thanks for these graduates, for their energy, questions, creativity, and growth. We give thanks for the teachers who taught and mentored them, for their families and friends who sacrificed and supported them. We acknowledge with sorrow the mistakes and hurts that were part of the journey. As we look forward to whatever comes next, new careers and opportunities, deeper thinking and writing and creating, we ask for help, for confidence and courage, and creativity. We need what these graduates have to offer, and so we ask for strength and perseverance and resilience for them. And finally, we are indeed wowed by and with these graduates. They are intelligent, compassionate, interesting, funny. We offer appreciation and wonder and joy for all that they have done, and anticipation and eagerness for all that they have yet to do. We give thanks, we seek forgiveness, we ask for what is needed, and we acknowledge wonder. May it be so. Amen.
Good afternoon. I'm Jose Antonio Bowman, president of Goucher College. I'd like to welcome you today to the 2015 Graduate Program's Commencement. This event constitutes the culmination of much hard work on the part of our graduates. Congratulations. I hope you have enjoyed your time at Goucher. I hope you've been inspired by the work that you've done, by our faith in you, and our aspirations for you. You are future leaders in the fields of education, the arts and administration, historic preservation, writing, and cultural sustainability. I hope you've been inspired by the quality of our faculty and by their dedication to you. Yes, they did force you to rewrite that paper and talk about your draft or design when you didn't want to hear it. No group of faculty in the world cares more about your success and well-being than do your teachers and staff from Goucher College. Our faculty are an incredibly accomplished group of professors. Among them, we have Pulitzer Prize winners, regional arts council directors, former school superintendents and principals, top administrators of national and state historic and cultural agencies, accomplished independent writers, as well as grant makers. But more importantly, they truly cared enough about you to set the bar very, very high. I hope you remember the personal attention, the honesty, the late nights and long conversations, the high standards, and mostly, how dedicated they remain to your success. Please come back and tell us what you're doing. We love connecting with alumni and getting a glimpse into how you're changing the world. As those of you about to embark on teaching careers are soon to find out, no one enters teaching for the money. We live for those moments when a student says, "You made a difference." So I ask the faculty of the Graduate Division of Goucher College to rise, please, so that we can all say thank you. Faculty, we are also very fortunate to have such a dedicated group of staff working to support faculty and students every day. They check out your books, fix your computers, answer our phones, clean our classrooms, and keep everything running so we can focus on creating great work. They've also worked very, very hard to create this event for all of us today. So most of them are backstage, but will the staff please stand so we can give them a round of applause also and show our appreciation. Thank you. You have also, of course, been supported along the way by many friends, family, mentors, and guides. Graduates look around at the supporters who stayed up with you while you rewrote that essay, drafted that plan, did mock interviews, checked your copy. Everyone needs a support system, and you have such an extensive one. You owe a special thanks even to your parents, friends, and relatives, and we ask all of those here today to stand so we can thank and honor our support systems. Thank you for being with us today. And above all, we are here today to celebrate the accomplishments of the class of 2015. This class embodies an amazing array of interests and explorations. One of our creative nonfiction students completed a series of essays called The Paris Project for The Week magazine, spending 3 months living and writing in the City of Light. Another student in Goucher's Cultural Sustainability Master's program traveled from Indonesia to Ireland and then back to her neighborhood in Rhode Island to tell the stories of three communities and their healers who are fighting to sustain their traditional healing practices in the face of rapidly globalizing pharmaceutically based medicine. She now serves as a community health worker, bridging the gap with patients in her own community. Our arts administration students have delved deep into many topics focused on ethical and social issues, including the social responsibility of the arts, the ethical dilemmas faced by today's nonprofits, and management approaches to ensure equity. A student in the Historic Preservation Program continues to work with site historians and interpreters to more fully address the uncomfortable truths and hushed silence that alienates many African Americans from their own history, which is also the central theme of her thesis. Our graduates in education include an MED candidate who is the new head men's soccer coach at York College, as well as a graduate who's the director of a charter school in Baltimore City, working alongside another education graduate who is an assistant director at the same school. The accomplishments of our students and our alumni and alumni have motivated and challenged us to be better faculty and better human beings. We have learned so much from each other and have created beautiful new ideas and work together. You, our graduates, have earned this degree and this moment of recognition. We have been honored to be here with you. Please stand now as we acknowledge you and the work that you've done to get here today. Our graduates. We have asked much of you, but now, of course, it's my job to ask of you one more thing. But it's simple. I ask you to remember that each of you has a unique ability to make the world a better place. Each of you carries a piece of the human puzzle that no one else has ever had. No one else has or ever will have. Your unique combination of creative drive, visual sensitivity, passion for music, and empathy for the underdog. Your talents, experiences, and purpose are singular. If you fail to make your unique contribution, that shortcoming can never be rectified. Ever. The world will lose something precious. Each of you is needed in a special way to make the world whole. That is a role that you and only you alone can play. You've already demonstrated at Goucher that you have the passion and persistence to work hard toward a difficult goal. Please continue. Find your unique contribution to the world and pursue it. We are so glad you've brought your talents and dreams to Goucher College. And now we say thank you and good luck.
The honorary degree will now be conferred. Wil Haygood will be presented by Leslie Rubenkowski, Director of the Master of Fine Arts Program in Creative Nonfiction.
Wil Haygood. As a renowned journalist, author, teacher, and movie producer, you've always worked hard, uncovering awe-inspiring stories of people, places, and movements that might otherwise fade into the collective din of history. Despite the challenging circumstances during your childhood in Columbus, Ohio, you excelled in writing. People who knew you then said they already recognized you were something special. You had a dream, and you worked for it, becoming the first in your family to attend college. You've taken hard work, vision, and moxie, and turned it into a career that looks outward and upward. It's not luck. It's you. For almost three decades, you worked tirelessly as a journalist, treading the planet as a national and foreign correspondent for the Boston Globe. Your work spanned natural disasters and the African AIDS epidemic, political campaigns and wars, including the Somali Civil War, during which you were captured as a hostage. As a journalist, you traveled through the swamplands of Louisiana with a campaigning former Grand Wizard of the KKK and rode into New Orleans as others fled after Hurricane Katrina. Your work with the Globe earned you more than a dozen journalism honors, including ranking as a Pulitzer Prize finalist. Later, you moved to the Washington Post, and during your coverage of the 2008 presidential campaign of Barack Obama, you wrote the story, A Butler Well Served by This Election. This inspiring look at the life of a White House butler was adapted into the 2013 blockbuster motion picture and expanded in your book, The Butler, A Witness to History, a New York Times bestseller. In the writing community, you're known for your humility and kindness, but to the public, you're known for the thought-provoking stories you've told in your multiple books. You've written about your own adventures, such as your 2,500-mile journey down the Mississippi River, your autobiography, which earned a New York Times notable book mention, and another book that won Book of the Year Award from the Black Caucus of the American Library Association. Your seventh and upcoming book, Showdown, Thurgood Marshall and the Supreme Court Nomination That Changed America, has already resulted in a John Simon Guggenheim Memorial Fellowship and a National Endowment for the Humanities Fellowship. You have said your writing has been a relentless pursuit to explain all of America, which you do by recounting small stories, especially those of heroic black men. You've been called a cultural historian, projecting the present onto a backdrop of history. You tell these tales of humanity and adventure while also serving as the Weep King Visiting Distinguished Professor at Miami University, Ohio, passing on your zest for journalism to students sitting where you once did. Wil Haygood, for your continued contributions to the world of journalism and literature, for the heightened awareness you have given to great men who change our nation in both and public ways, and for being a model to all writers, we present you with the Doctor of Humane Letters.
Now I have to read the good bit. By the authority of the State of Maryland, vested in the trustees of Goucher College and by them delegated to me, I confer on Wil Haygood the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. Congratulations. I now take great pride in welcoming our commencement speaker, Wil Haygood. Please join me in welcoming him to Goucher College.
It seems like the older I get, the less I mind people saying wonderful things about me. Sort of reminds me, someone once said about Cary Grant, and that Cary Grant had gone to a film festival and there were all these wonderful things being said about him. And Cary Grant said, my, I'd like to meet that Cary Grant someday myself. Thank you, Leslie, for your lovely, lovely introduction. It's funny, I know I will never get the big head. I have sisters. They ask me for money, and if I'm a little slow in sending it to them, they will say, "Well, just because you know Oprah Winfrey, you ain't all that." She appeared in the Butler movie. Speaking of the movie, someone just asked me what's changed in my life the most since the release of the movie and all of the worldwide attention that it received. And I have to say, not a lot, really, has changed. However, I am a little amused that since the movie's release, I have heard from both of the ladies who turned me down for the high school prom. Now, one of the ladies said, "Surely, Will, baby, you aren't holding a grudge about what happened all those years ago, are you?" And I said, "Now why in the world would I hold a grudge about what happened on May 22nd at 3:00 in the afternoon outside of Miss Johnston's homeroom class when I asked you to go to that little, old, insignificant high school prom with me?" That's life. Thank you, President Bowen, for this very special opportunity to address today's graduates. I'd also like to thank the First Lady of Goucher, who co-hosted a great luncheon for me earlier today. The sliced tomatoes were dynamite. I'm very happy also to be joined here today with my dear friend Patsy Sims, who for many years directed the esteemed MFA program in writing. I was quite honored to deliver the Patsy Sims lecture on campus yesterday. And I know for sure that Goucher is very happy to have Leslie Rubenkowski now serving in the wonderful role that Patsy Sims held here. We live, as you know, in very perilous times with threats to freedom, almost constant, it seems. So I would like to thank all the military veterans, past and present, who are here, who have served this great nation of ours. Graduates, you are all here today because you're getting your master's degrees. I'm so very impressed and in awe. When I was in college, I mastered not a thing. I majored in just holding on. And I graduated summa cum lucky. But what is so unique about the position you are in is this. You chose to return to college. You chose to take your intellect to a higher level at this great institution. If the problems of the world today, such as poverty and discrimination and sexism, seem almost intractable, that only means higher passions must be used to conquer those problems. You have taken your mind to another level. You have taken your discipline to another level. You have taken your goals to another level. You already know about the world of artists and the world of teaching and history and saving things. A word about teaching. And I mean teaching by example because of your exalted learning experience. Once on assignment in Somalia, where a civil war was going on, I was escorted to a secret hiding place. Two little sandal-footed kids scooting along in front of me. The village elders had insisted I see the treasures they had risked their life to hide from the rebels. When I heard the word treasures, of course, I thought of diamonds and pearls, sparkly things. I finally reached this secret location. The room was in a little small cave. It was dark and very dusty, but I could tell that the two elderly men standing there were quite proud. They pulled a blanket back and showed me the village's treasures. Those treasures were books. Yes, books. These are our treasures, one of the men said, and we must stop the rebels from burning these books. They let me know the first thing rebels do when they invade a village is burn books. Why? Because in the books there is knowledge. And of course, knowledge might lead one to understand that life can be about more than war and hatred and strife. I love books. And so I nearly cried when I witnessed what the brave people of that village were doing to keep those books safe. I ask those of you here today, as you leave this campus, find a good book as often as you can. Lay it in someone's palm. Be a master of generosity. Guide our children deep into those books, where they might find answers to lift their lives upward. Your mission from saving a building, to writing a story, to leading a dance company, is crucial. A word about art, about the beautiful symmetry of living and seeing, of reporting and writing. There was this little child, Elvira, born in Selma, Alabama, that civil rights-soaked city in 1932. Her family was not treated as equal citizens. From the ballot box to access to the downtown stores, they were not treated equally. So her father, James, went north to Ohio and settled there in the mid-1940s. By 1954, Elvira, now all grown, gave birth to a little boy. She was not in the best of health, and the little boy had to be placed in an incubator for 6 weeks. Now, 1954, the year of that little boy's birth, was also the year that Thurgood Marshall, the great civil rights attorney from right here in Baltimore, won the NAACP's epic school desegregation lawsuit at the Supreme Court, knocking down the doctrine of separate but equal. So, Elvira's little boy was born right on the cusp of freedom. And that little boy would grow up to become a writer. And, lo and behold, 6 years ago, set out to write a book about Thurgood Marshall. Why Thurgood Marshall? Well, because that little boy has always been haunted by that particular year, 1954, when freedom came and touched him in his baby's crib. That little boy grew up and fell in love with books. I am that little boy. You must dream. You set yourselves on this exalted course, mastering certain disciplines. So, dream higher. Dream harder. While I was researching my Thurgood Marshall book, I came across a letter while going through the archives of Senator John McClellan of Arkansas. He was a segregationist and did not want Thurgood Marshall on the Supreme Court. The letter I came across was written by Barbara Ross of Texarkana, Arkansas. In her letter, she described herself as a, quote, law-abiding Negro and an American. She had heard the reports coming out of Washington about the Senate hearings Marshall was enduring. They were tough hearings, and many wondered if he'd make it onto the court. The chances are, Barbara Ross wrote to her senator, are that the nomination will be turned down. But let Mr. Marshall's record speak for itself. Skin color doesn't make the person senator. It is character that makes the man. If Thurgood Marshall doesn't get the nomination, there will be others who will seek the same opportunity. There will be hundreds, Senator, and you can't fight them all. Somebody will get it. One of these days, the President of the United States will be a black man. Miss Barbara Ross was only 20 years old when she wrote that brave letter. She was a dreamer. And just look who's in the White House right now. I spoke to Ms. Ross 2 weeks ago. She still lives in Texarkana. She is retired now from teachers, a lifetime of teaching. I can't wait to meet her in person on my book tour. I now dream of the moment when I will be knocking on her front door. When you leave this campus today, you must become the best artists and educators and administrators that you can be. Believe in great poetry, as I know you do, and believe in great love stories. Believe that miracles can happen, because they do. That's the ultimate gift of time, the ability to believe and dream. This year, we celebrate the 50th anniversary of the 1965 Voting Rights Act. I once met a butler, worked in the White House for 8 presidents. He worked at the most powerful address in the world, 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue, and on the weekends he could go back to his native hometown in Virginia and couldn't try on a suit or a hat in a men's clothing store because of the color of his skin. That butler was a dreamer. He dreamed about all of us, and that one day freedom would come. He got a gift from President Kennedy when he himself was dreaming about the Civil Rights Bill that was ultimately passed by his successor, President Lyndon Johnson. The gift was a gold-plated tie clip, a very precious gift. After my story came out about Mr. Allen, he called me to his house and he said, "I'd like you to have this." And he had something in the palm of his hand, and it was the tie clip that he had gotten from President John F. Kennedy. I told him that there was no way I could take that. He had earned that. And he said, "I must." I'm wearing that tie clip today in honor of you and what you have achieved. So dream. Dream for a butler. Dream for the people still fighting for their right to vote in some communities. Dream that you will do glorious things with what you have learned and how you will walk righteously from this campus today. Thank you, and God bless you.
The awards and prizes for outstanding students and graduates for our programs will now be given.
Good afternoon. I'm Richard Wagner, Director of the Preservation Program in Historic Preservation. Established in 1999 by the Master of Arts in Historic Preservation faculty member Antoinette Lee, in memory of her parents, Stephen and Catherine, the Lee Prize recognizes excellence in projects and papers undertaken by students that address the preservation of America's diverse heritage. This year, the recipient of the Lee Prize is Marion McGinnis for her paper, Uptown Girl, The Anderson Flats and the West End, submitted for HP 613 Urban History. Established in 1995 by Ann McCullough Pettit, a member of Goucher class of 1960 and well-known Maryland preservationist in memory of her father and great-grandfather, Hiram McCullough, the Hiram McCullough Award in Historic Preservation is presented each year to the students submitting the most outstanding thesis. This year, the award goes to Maria Lopez Martinez for her thesis, The Coast in Peril, Preserving Puerto Rico's Historic Resources from Sea Level Rise. Established in 2014 by the Master of Arts in Historic Preservation Program, the Distinguished Alumnus Award recognizes one of our graduates' contributions to the field of historic preservation since earning his degree. The recipient is nominated by the program's faculty. This year, the recipient is Brian Michael Leone. Since 2014, Brian has been Executive Director of the Iraqi Institute for Conservation of Antiquities and Heritage, where he develops and implements international standards for the conservation of architectural and archaeological heritage in Iraq. Prior to assuming his current position, Mr. Leone was director of the Iraqi Cultural Heritage Project by the U.S. Embassy to provide expertise and training to rebuilding Iraq's cultural professionals.
I'm now pleased to present the Historic Preservation Alumnus Award. In 2002, the Alumna Alumnus Award was established by Tobin Tracy and Robert Benedict, the first two graduates of the Goucher Master of Arts Program in Historic Preservation. The award honors an outstanding first-year historic preservation student and is awarded on the basis of the final paper in the course Introduction to Historic Preservation. Today, I'm honored to announce the winner of the 2014 Alumna Award is Carrie Lynn Ragland for her paper written for the course entitled Sea Level Rise and Historic Structure Salvage.
Hello again. I am pleased to present the two Christine White Creative Nonfiction Awards. The judge for this year's award in literary journalism was the author and essayist Will S. Hilton. He described the author of this year's winning submission as showing a remarkable breadth of quality. In the depth of reporting, the quality of prose, and perhaps most uncommonly in the greater construct of story architecture, which drifted effortlessly between exposition and narrative, never giving too much away and raising new questions in my mind, even as it answered others. A tremendous example of narrative nonfiction in motion. The winner for Sex, Money, Murder is Jonathan Green. The judge for the essay memoir category was Hattie Fletcher, the managing editor of the journal Creative Nonfiction. Of this year's winner, she said that, quote, the author has clearly done significant legwork and research to be able to convincingly recreate not only dramatic scenes, but also the emotional tone of an era. And although it's an excerpt from a longer work, it stands alone well while hinting at the larger narrative and themes. The winner for They Said They Wanted Revolution, a memoir of my parents, Berkeley, and the Iranian Revolution is Neda Semnani.
Good afternoon. I'm Ramona Baker. I'm director of the Arts Administration Program here at Goucher. I'm pleased to present the Gene Wilhelm Award. The Gene Wilhelm Award was established to honor the founder of Goucher's Master of Arts in Arts Administration Program. It is presented each year to the student with the most outstanding thesis paper, as recommended by the faculty and determined by a panel of outside readers. The recipient of the Gene Wilhelm Award this year is Ava Truman Morgan. The paper chosen for the Wilhelm Award this year explores the ethical dilemma posed by technology. Capable of enhancing the visitor's experience in museums, technology can also have unintended adverse effects. Administrators and curators are encouraged to consider both the positive and the negative impacts of technology in Ava's thesis paper, The Ethics of Engagement, Visual Arts Museums, and the Effect of Technology on the Visitor Experience. Ava.
Good afternoon. I'm Gay Brown, Director of the Master of Education Program, and I'm delighted to present the Action Research Prize. The Action Research Prize, established in 2006, is given to a graduating student whose action research study represents an exceptionally high level of achievement in research design, execution, data analysis, and writing. This year, there are two prize recipients. The first found that cross-age mentoring had a significant impact on the disruptive behavior of first and second graders. I'm very pleased to announce that the first August 2015 Action Research Prize goes to Chanel Glee. The second recipient studied the impact of repeated reading with struggling third grade readers. She found that this strategy can be beneficial in improving students' motivation in reading. I'm pleased to announce that the second Action Research Prize goes to Laura Rousey.
My name is Lynn Blackman, and I'm the director of the Master of Arts in Teaching program. I'm here to present the Elizabeth Dean Special Education Award. The Elizabeth Dean Special Education Award, established in 2006, is given in recognition of an MAT graduate who most exemplifies the qualities of the former special education coordinator, Dr. Dean. Dr. Dean exhibited a commitment to excellence, a high regard for all students, and a strong positive outlook. The supervisor of this year's recipient states, quote, her enthusiasm, effort, creativity, and caring approach to the instruction of severe and profound special education youngsters are extraordinary. The winner of the 2015 Beth Dean Award is Mary Abigail Wilson. Unfortunately, Ms. Wilson could not be here with us today, so I will accept the award on her behalf. Thank you.
My name is Amy Skillman, Director of the Master of Arts in Cultural Sustainability, and I'm pleased to present the Cultural Sustainability Prize. The prize is named in honor of Dr. Rory Turner, Goucher faculty and founder of the Master of Arts in Cultural Sustainability. Dr. Turner is nationally known for his innovative work with creative expression in cultural contexts. His passion and energy have fostered a professional graduate program that engages students in critical reflection and promotes community vitality and social justice. The recipient of the 2015 Rory Turner Prize in Cultural Sustainability is Heidi Thomas for her capstone entitled Urban Agriculture and the Co-Development of Environment, Culture, and Community. Three finalists were selected and forwarded to John Hawkes, one of Australia's leading commentators on cultural policy and author of the groundbreaking fourth pillar of sustainability. In his assessment, he wrote, Heidi's paper is engrossing. On the one hand, breathtakingly mundane, on the other, sweepingly visionary. We all know that food production and consumption are economic, environmental, and social issues. By introducing a cultural perspective, Heidi has simultaneously demonstrated how much meaning is inherent in what and how we feed ourselves, and shown how useful and necessary cultural analysis is when addressing community development issues. He adds, I found all three finalists captivating, illuminating, challenging, and admirable, and no one more so than the others. But Heidi's paper is likely to have the most profound repercussions. Urban agriculture is a global phenomenon in need of a comprehensive, rigorous, and accessible rationale. Heidi has taken a big step in getting us there.
The awarding of the degrees will begin. All guests are asked to remain in their seats and to keep the aisles clear during the awarding of the degrees. Will the candidates for the degree of Master of Arts in Arts Administration please rise? Provost Lewis will present the candidates to Marilyn Warshawski, former board chair and long-serving board of trustees member and President Bowen.
Ms. Warshawski, Mr. President, I have the honor to inform you that these candidates have fulfilled all the requirements for graduation, and in accordance with the recommendation of the faculty, they are presented for the degree of Master of Arts in Arts Administration.
By the authority of the State of Maryland, vested in the trustees of Goucher College and by them delegated to me, I confer on you the degree of Master of Arts in Arts Administration with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Will the recipients of the degree of Master of Arts in Arts Administration come forward as your name is called to receive your diploma? The recipients are Aisha Simone Carr, Deidre Michelle Montgomery. Ava Truman Morgan. Adam Scanlon Nikolai. Sarah Augusta Reich. Jennifer Christine Redderer. Catherine Louise Schmidt Fader. Jennifer Jane Williams. Bridget Elaine Woodbury. Please join us in congratulating all Master of Arts in Arts Administration graduates.
Will the candidates for the degree of Master of Arts in Cultural Sustainability please rise?
Ms. Warshawski, Mr. President, I have the honor to inform you that these candidates have fulfilled all the requirements for graduation, and in accordance with the recommendation of the faculty, they are presented for the degree of Master of Arts in Cultural Sustainability.
By the authority of the State of Maryland, vested in the trustees of Goucher College and by them delegated to me, I confer on you the degree of Master of Arts in Cultural Sustainability, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Will the recipients of the degree of Master of Arts in Cultural Sustainability come forward as your name is called to receive your diploma? The recipients are Benjamin Jacob Bean, Dalen C. Butler, Alexandra W. Coe, Caitlin O'Shea Farley, Randy Muller, Shannon Marie Smith, and Heidi C. Thomas. Please join us in congratulating all Master of Arts in Cultural Sustainability graduates.
Will the candidates for the degree Master of Arts in Historic Preservation please rise?
Ms. Warshawski, Mr. President, I have the honor to inform you that these candidates have fulfilled all the requirements for graduation, and in accordance with the recommendation of the faculty, they are presented for the degree of Master of Arts in Historic Preservation.
By the authority of the State of Maryland, vested in the trustees of Goucher College and by them delegated to me, I confer on you the degree of Master of Arts in Historic Preservation, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Will the recipients of the degree of Master of Arts in Historic Preservation come forward as your name is called to receive your diploma? The recipients are Nicole Francis Brannon, Catherine E. Doak Kessler, Gloria D. Hall, Maria Lopez Martinez, Robert Victor Maimone, please join us in congratulating all the Master of Arts in Historic Preservation graduates.
Will the candidates for the degree Master of Arts in Teaching please rise?
Ms. Warshawski, Mr. President, I have the honor to inform you that these candidates have fulfilled all the requirements for graduation, and in accordance with the recommendation of the faculty, they are presented for the degree of Master of Arts in Teaching.
By the authority of the State of Maryland, vested in the trustees of Goucher College and by them delegated to me, I confer on you the degree of Master of Arts in Teaching, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Will the recipients of the degree of Master of Arts in Teaching come forward as your name is called to receive your diploma? The recipients are Eileen McGrath Bilo, Christian Garvin Bond, Maria Sita Braxton, Billy J. Cooper, Lawrence Alexander Costella, Timothy Scott Cronin, Jody Nicole Dolansky, Courtney Simone Lax, Lauren Elizabeth Leahy, Thomas Alexander Maddox, Kendra Mason, Mary Elizabeth McCarthy. Sarah Smott McGrain. Amanda L. Pfeffer. Jennifer Rosen. Maximilian Patrick Suvold. Robin Thompson. Anzuna Tori. John Patrick Ward. Fatima Winky Stokes. Please join us in congratulating all the Master of Arts in Teaching graduates.
Will the candidates for the degree of Master of Education please rise?
Ms. Warshawski, Mr. President, I have the honor to inform you that these candidates have fulfilled all the requirements for graduation, and in accordance with the recommendation of the faculty, they are presented for the degree of Master of Education.
By the authority of the State of Maryland, vested in the trustees of Goucher College and by them delegated to me, I confer on you the degree of Master of Education, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Will the recipients of the degree of Master of Education come forward as your name is called to receive your diploma? The recipients are Brian James Owey, Sandra Barnaby, Kenya Kevon Beard, Amy Levack Bloomberg, Erica Tabert Bluen, Maria Anilo Bolander, Paul Alan Brenner, Sydney Allen Brooks, Alexandra Weir Chambers, Jacqueline E. Cheney, Erica Katerina Confer Weimer, Shirella Cupid, Emma Caroline Damvakaris, Catherine Edna Marie Dobry, Hannah Lamontagne Douglas, Hannah Alicia Anne Etienne. Joshua Jerome Faraday. Chanel Loriana Glee. Megan Kathleen Haberkam. Kia Janae Harper. Scott Anthony Hawks. Joseph Sean Kramer. Elizabeth April Lafferty. Laura Kathleen Lindsay. Sarah Anna McCauley. Eric McCray. Jessica Sarah Meredith. Sarah Lane Neff. Alexander Paul Paradise. Abigail Paris. Chelsea Ann Plant. Laura Ann Rousey. Jennifer Laura Stanton. Kylie Nicole Stash. Jennifer Laura Szymanski. Gittel Tritel. Jernelle Jaron Ward. Catherine Lawrence Wes. Alicia Woodruff. Please join us in congratulating all the Master of Education graduates.
Will the candidates for the degree of Master of Fine Arts in Creative Nonfiction please rise?
Ms. Warshawski, Mr. President, I have the honor to inform you that these candidates have fulfilled all the requirements for graduation, and in accordance with the recommendation of the faculty, they are presented for the degree of Master of Fine Arts in Creative Nonfiction.
By the authority of the State of Maryland, vested in the trustees of Goucher College and by them delegated to me, I confer on you the degree of Master of Fine Arts in Creative Nonfiction, with all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Will the recipients of the degree of Master of Fine Arts in Creative Nonfiction come forward as your name is called to receive your diploma? The recipients are Dana Lynn Bailey, Christina Rebecca Gaddy. Jonathan Green. Jean Carolyn Guerrero. Anita Rivera Huslin. Erica Branch Johnson. Delcy Kincaid. Virginia McReynolds. Ruth Nasrullah. Ann Loomis Roberts. Parisa Sarange. Netta Tulu Semnani. Anita Kathleen Snow. Please join us in congratulating all the Master of Fine Arts and Creative Nonfiction graduates. Of the graduates, please rise for a final round of applause in recognition of the hard work that has brought you here today.
Now I'd like to introduce Todd Eric Hawkins, MAAA, Class of 2010, and President of the Alumni Association of Goucher College.
Good afternoon. 5 years ago, I sat right where you are today as a graduate of the Master's of Arts and Arts Administration program. Today, as the president of the alumni and alumni of Goucher College, it is my great privilege and sincere honor to induct the class of 2015 into the Alumni and Alumni Association. Will the class of 2015 please stand? On behalf of the alumni and alumni of Goucher College, which we call the AAGC, it is my pleasure to honor your achievement in graduating from this institution. I know firsthand how hard you have worked to get you to this point and the dedication you have all exhibited. Congratulations on your new standing as a graduate, alumna, or alumnus. You have joined more than 14,000 active alumni, all 50 states and all 52 countries. And 52 countries. There are more. We wish you well as you begin the next phase of your lives. Stay in touch and stay connected to Goucher. I look forward to congratulating you personally at the reception following today's ceremony, which the AAGC is pleased to co-sponsor in the celebration of your accomplishments. For this day forward, you are a successful alumnae or alumni of Goucher College, and I welcome you to the community. Thank you.
The exercise will close with the benediction. Following the benediction, the audience is requested to remain in their seats as the academic procession is passed. Family members and guests are invited to join the faculty and graduates at the reception in the Rosenberg Gallery at the conclusion of the recessional.
I'm Rabbi Josh Snyder, Executive Director of Goucher Hillel. As a benediction today, I want to balance and reconcile two rabbinic sayings from Pirkei Avot, Ethics of the Fathers. The first, Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai would say, "If you have gained much knowledge, do not take credit for it yourself. It is for this that you have been formed." The second saying, Rabbi Hanina ben Dosa would say, "One whose deeds exceed his wisdom endures, but one whose wisdom exceeds her deeds, her wisdom will not endure." The first statement makes a value judgment that knowledge is supreme, even that it is our reason for existence. It reminds us to be humble, as we are merely instruments of the knowledge that we are lucky enough to possess. Human beings among beasts are uniquely able to store vast amounts of knowledge on various subjects. But the second statement would imply that knowledge is subservient to action. If one attempts merely to store information, we know a great deal will likely be lost. But when knowledge is put into practice, especially within a few hours of acquisition, it sticks. We've been given the great gift of our minds so that we can make use of our knowledge. Then we can truly be called wise. As you leave here and apply your newly gained knowledge and experience, may each of you find ample opportunity to put it to good use. Administer, sustain, preserve, teach, educate, write, and inspire. May you be blessed and kept from all harm. May you find goodness and grace on all the paths you face. And may your striving for purpose endow you with a sense of peace.